For question number 7, the correct option is option 4. That is, this graph is the correct graph. Let's see why. You recall this relation between free fall acceleration and the distance below and above Earth's surface. We have learnt in the theory class that at a depth of h below the Earth's surface, free fall acceleration g, I'm calling it g dash, is given by the formula, the standard value g on the Earth's surface into 1 minus h by r. Now in this formula, let me show you the figure quickly. This is the Earth, this is the Earth center, and you go to a depth of h below the Earth's surface. Radius of the Earth is r, and therefore the distance of this point from the Earth's center, that they are calling as d, this d is equal to r minus h, isn't it? At a depth of h below Earth's surface, distance from the Earth's center is r minus h, that is they are calling d. Therefore, I can write this as simply g into r minus h by r, and it follows therefore that g dash is equal to g by r into d. R minus h is d shown here. So g by r is a constant because g is the free fall acceleration on the Earth's surface, a standard value of 9.8 meter per second square. R is Earth's radius, a constant, and therefore this quantity g by r is a constant. And you can simply write down that free fall acceleration g dash is equal to a constant k into d, which is the distance from the Earth center. Now this equation reminds us of standard equation of a straight line, y is equal to mx, a straight line having slope of m passing through the origin. So if g dash is given by simply kd, k being a constant, the graph of g versus d has to be a straight line from the Earth center up to the Earth surface, that is where d is equal to r. So between d is equal to 0 and d is equal to r, the graph must be a straight line as given by this equation. You can have a look at these four graphs and see that options 1, 2 and 3, they are giving curved part here, and therefore you must choose as a correct option, option number 4. And that should be the end of the question. You must go to the next question to save time. However, for the sake of completeness, let me remind you another thing about this part of the graph. I am saying once again, you already got the correct option, that is option number 4, and you shouldn't waste any more time on this question, must move to the next question. But for our students, we just discuss a little more on that. How does g vary with height above the Earth surface, right? Once again, I choose the Earth center and a point at a height h above the Earth surface. So if this distance is taken to be h, r being the Earth's radius, this distance, that d, now becomes r plus h above Earth's surface. And the formula you have learnt in theory class is g dash is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. Now this is giving me g r square by r plus h whole square, that is nothing but d square. So I'm getting eventually that above the Earth's surface, g dash is varying inversely as the square of distance, isn't it? If g dash is equal to g r squared by d square, g being a constant, the value of free fall acceleration on Earth's surface, or is Earth's radius a constant, so g r squared is a constant, g dash varying inversely the square of distance from the Earth's center above the Earth's surface. For that case, the graph must be a curve such that at a large value of d, this g approaches 0, and that is the case here. So we just insist once again, the graph number 4 is the correct option for us.